question real quickly about the classification. So the bolt and clamp provision, that provision kind of invited you to engage in a tariff shifting analysis. Some questions which seemingly inviting you to test in the tariff shifting analysis are not really about tariff shifting. So let's see, let's take a look at this one. The importer of men's pants from Mexico gives the broker a certificate of origin showing that the fabric and all processing originated, was performed in Mexico, right? So here we have a following situation. We have everything made in Mexico, all the fabric from Mexico and all the processing from Mexico. And the pants are at this duty rate. So it's a given, right? How you will enter this pants? So first thing to look for is to look for HTS number and see if that classification is available. If the special treatment for 6203, 41, 6010 is available, if there is a NAFTA available. Because as soon as you see Mexico over here, your inquiry is NAFTA available. All right, so let's go to the classification table and see what comes up. All right, so we have this provision, 41.9 cents per kilogram plus 16.3% or free. And we have Mexico over here. So the question is, does it qualify under the general rate or does it qualify under special NAFTA rate because of the Mexican presence over here? This is where this is the point of the question. All right, so given that, we go to the general note, and we know that everything was made in Mexico, right? So the question is, does it originate in Mexico, in territory of Mexico? We go to the note B, goods originating in the territory of an after party. This is one of the criteria. Another one is a marking, but here the point is not a marking. And here is the subparagraph B3. If the goods are produced entirely in territory of Mexico, exclusively from originating materials, then they qualify as originating. Let's go back to the fact pattern. And we see that everything was originating, processing in Mexico, right? Therefore, duty-free provision is applicable. So therefore, you have duty-free provision under NAFTA, right? So B is correct answer choice because this particular product qualifies for this column, not this column. Understand? Now, of course, C is obviously incorrect. The other ones, they're quite interesting because they're designed to throw you off. You have Central American Free Trade Agreement, also known as DR-CAFTA, right? You have to know the list of countries, but it's easy to exclude because when you see Mexico, when you see Canada, or United States for that matter, think NAFTA, right? Nothing else but North American Free Trade Agreement. So this is just designed to throw you off. GSP is also designed to throw you off. NAFTA doesn't, Mexico is not part of GSP, it's part of NAFTA. And you have Andean Trade Promotion Right to Eradication Act, that's now has been repealed, it has been changed into the countries from from this particular trade agreement have been changed or transformed to various other free trade agreements, such as Colombia trade agreement, free trade agreement. So it's really no longer around. So again, it's just designed to throw you off. So B, because everything was made, is appropriate number, is appropriate answer choice, and no tariff shifting is necessary because everything comes from Mexico. So this is pretty easy to answer.